Let me just say, I'm not a historian, but I love a good story. Liver Eating Johnson is a fascinating character. However, John Garrison, or John Johnson, aka Liver Eating Johnson, was a documented true historical figure whose story is bigger than life. There was a popular book written about him called Crow Killer, and a movie loosely based on him, without the liver eating and other good parts, called Jeremiah Johnson, starring Robert Redford. Liver Eating Johnson's birth name was John Garrison. He was born in Hunterdon County, New Jersey in 1824. Part of his early history started when he lied about his age to enlist in the Navy. He went AWOL after striking an officer. He deserted and went out west to start a new life as a mountain man. After that, he went by the name John Johnson. He befriended the Flathead Indians and married a beautiful Flathead woman known as the Swan. He settled into a mountain cabin with his new Indian bride to trap and hunt grizzly bear. Sometimes he was out a week at a time or longer. One time while he was out on a hunting trip, a party of Crow Indians broke into the cabin, ransacked it, killed his wife and unborn child. The whole point of Johnson becoming a mountain man was to get away from people, violence, and just to find some peace. So you could imagine the horror when he returned to that cabin. That party of Crow Indian may have just murdered a woman and her child, but they were about to find out what violence was all about. Liver Eating Johnson tracked down that party of Crow warriors. He found them asleep and killed many of them before they woke up. He scalped them alive, and in his rage, he cut out many of their livers while they were still living and took a bite out of them. The Crow Indian believed that their livers were necessary to get them into the spirit world after they died. A few from that party of Crow were able to escape. When word got back to the Crow chief, especially the horror in which they were slaughtered and the disgrace that one man can kill so many out of the party, the chief selected 20 of his strongest battle-tested warriors and instructed them to one at a time hunt down and kill Liver Eating Johnson. One by one, and eventually all 20 of these Crow warriors were found beaten to death, scalped, with their livers cut out and eaten. This was particularly terrifying to the Crow, since they believed the liver contained the soul. Johnson was a big and sturdy man. Part of his life was working as a woodhawk. And what a woodhawk did was they supplied heavy timber to shipbuilders. It was like lifting weights. He was a formidable 6 foot tall, 260 pounds, and said to be rock solid. Another incident was when Johnson was selling whiskey to the Blackfoot Indians. They ambushed and captured him in order to sell him to the Crow. They stripped him down to the waist, and it was the coldest part of the winter, and tied him up with leather straps. He managed to break the straps, overpowered and knocked out the guard, took the guard's knives, then cut off one of the guard's legs for food, and escaped into the frigid mountains. Liver Eating Johnson has killed over 300 Crow over his 25-year one-man war with them. He was feared by all the tribes, but eventually he did make peace with the Crow. I'm sure there's a lot more to this story. I know that he eventually rejoined the Union Army and was part of the cavalry. He was honorably discharged in 1865, and he became a town marshal in Red Lodge, Montana. So in his life, he was a sailor, soldier, lumberjack, mountain man, whiskey salesman, and a lawman. He died January 21st, 1900. He was about 75 years old. He's now buried in Cody, Montana, where there's a monument in his name. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, please hit the like button. Also, if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.